Hi, Barry Myers, Rochelt, Wisconsin. I own Barry's Body Shop for 35 years now, and it's all I pretty much do is semi-trucks, customizing, whatever. You got to look at the Barry Did It sticker, and that'll tell you it's a great job.
And what are we looking at here?
1967 K100, 3408 cat, 10-speed transmission, 235 wheelbase. I bought it burnt, completely restored it all the way, rewired it, re-airlined it, put all the chrome and all that stuff, pretty much made it all myself. And I got a 69 Fruehauf 40-foot trailer, factory air ride, 13.6 tall. It used to haul dynamite for Tri-State out of Joplin. It took me like 50 years to get that trailer. So. But it was a good find. It was a good hookup with this. You know, got it going and had a dream, and that's what I got when I got done.
So how did you come up with the really cool gradient stripe? I have never seen that on anything before.
I get to sniff paint fumes for a living, so that's... No, it was...
Like
I actually had to paint the whole truck that, so it was yellow, orange, and red. And then I taped all that off, and that's what I ended up with, just that little bit. It's always got to have a brake stripe, as far as I'm concerned, when you're doing stripes like that. And it actually looked pretty cool, all yellow, orange, and red, too. But then the black and white thing, I don't know. It just was one of them things. You're going along, and as you go, it's kind of like you had an idea, but then you change, and that's how I came up with all that.
Like while you were painting it?
Yeah. I didn't know what colors I wanted, and it's just kind of one of those things, you know. As you're going, you just kind of make it up, and you're, well, this, and I, maybe I'll change my mind and do that, and that's how I ended up with all that. I shaved the wipers off the front, and they're hidden upside down underneath the sun visor because they were air wipers before. I got a Peterbilt air cleaner turned sideways. That's there, and then I took the screen from that and made a turbo cover. I got the whole inside of the doghouse wrapped in stainless. It was a factory air-conditioned truck and had a passenger window, was electric. I took and grabbed the whole bunch of interior out of all Kenworths and made it to fit my truck on the inside. It's all diamond tufted. 22-inch front bumper.
Speaking of the interior, how about the dash? Is that?
That's all factory dash, wow. Yep, that's all original. And most of the gauges are all original. There was a few I had to replace, but I found all the original gauges for it to put back in. The spotlights are from a 61 bubble top Chevy. The CB antennas are the backside of a bullet marker light, and it's cut off so it hides the wire and the bracket because they don't make anything pretty for that. Uh-huh. I wrapped the whole frame in stainless steel. The tanks are 150-gallon fuel tanks. The step also comes out, as you got a video of that yesterday, yep.
Did you just think that up?
Yeah, me and a bottle of vodka. But yeah, this has been my best friend since I did it. It's been quite a deal. And I was, it was just one of them things where I got it and I had, you know, I wanted something old. And like I said, once I got going on it, this is what I ended up with.
And the trailer's a work in progress, that camper?
Well, yeah. Oh, yeah. Plus I made that a living quarters.
Like a month ago?
Yep. I got it done just the weekend after Labor Day. But I took a camper. I bought my neighbor's camper and cut the ends off and slid that in there. And then made my own bedroom and living room on the back of that. It's 26 feet of trailer taken up. And then I got enough room in the back to haul a golf cart and generator and cooler. Got to have a cooler.
What about the kegerator and the margarita machine?
Yeah, right. Yeah, all the boxes underneath that hold all the my cleaning supplies, and all the sewer pipes and all the electrical stuff, the battery that runs the trailer. I turned the turbo wing upside down and trimmed it down and cut that back and 4-quarter fenders together.
And the lights that you used for
these? I used that old headlight from a Peterbilt to get the airlines, and both on the trailer and the truck. I actually got about $15 in a headlight, and I get more compliments on that than anything. Yeah, some guy gave me the headlight, so it was a pretty cool deal. But yeah, it gets a lot of looks going on the road. It's a fun thing.
And you just take it to shows all over
the
place?
Just now, yeah. Yep. And that's what, you know, I'm painting all the time, so... But it's kind of my advertising, you know, if somebody wants to see what I do, they can just look at that and get a pretty good idea of what's going on over there.